Thank you very much, Petunia Gilbert, the queen of labor. Central Boston is going to take it home, I believe. And I was just going to say a lot of things, you know. But when I listened to Petunia, she said everything I was going to say. The good policies of labor. So I ain't going to say nothing more. I ain't going to say nothing more. She said everything I was going to say. Comrades, I want to invite to the podium to speak the lady, the darling, the representative of the people of Central Bastia. But I want to say to you before she comes that Marcella taught me in school at the Keown High School when I was there as a boy studying English. And I have learned a lot from Marcella. Not only is she a good teacher, or was she a good teacher, but she taught me values and principles. She taught me selflessness, values. And I believe that the people of Central Bastia have the best representative that they can have at this time. Because Marcella is a woman who believes in making sacrifices. Sacrifices for the people of the constituency and the country. Dwyer came, got his pension, and gone. Sam came, qualified for his pension, and said he now could kick labor in the behind. Timothy came, got his pension, and said it's time for him to go. He can kick down. He can kick down the pail of milk. He doesn't care anymore. But Marcella Leibard is here to stay and to represent the people of Central Bastia. So I want you to come out on Monday and march with Marcella Leibard. We have 10,000 t-shirts, collect yours tomorrow and Saturday, but definitely before Monday. We have our bumper stickers, 10,000 of them, collect them before Monday. And colleagues, I want you now to put your hands together in full confidence, and welcome to the podium the Queen of Labour, the Darling of Labour, the representative of the people of Central Bastia. Give it up for Marcella Leibard.
Natural beauty. No, I've never been someone shy until I seen your eyes. Still I had to try. Yeah. Oh yes. Let me get my words right and then approach you. When I'll treat you like a man is supposed to, you'll never have to cry. No. I know everyone can relate to when they find a special someone. And she's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life. I never know anymore.
Comrades and friends of labor,
yes.
Good night to you.
Yes.
Good night to the good people of Central Bastia and Upper Market Street. We are at home here in Upper Market Street. Good night to you. And all the other comrades from the other constituencies, we welcome you to Central Bastia. And of course, we have to say a very special good night to the women of Central Bastia and the women of labor. Good night to you. Thank you so very much. Comrades, we've been through it all, but we're still here. We're still here. And I'm very happy to see so many of you out here this evening. Can't talk the Spanish like my good comrade Nigel. So I'll just say, buenas noches, mi amigos. Thank you, Lily. You did a wonderful job. And also the contestant for Central Bastia, and Carissa Willett for her beautiful rendition of that very beautiful song, We're Still Here. as usual, we have to begin with our condolences. But before I do that, I must hail up all of those persons in the diaspora, Ghislaine Williams and all the others there in New York and Canada and Miami and England, who are watching us right now and sending us texts, enjoying what's happening here and seeing you, the good people, and identifying you as well. So we say good night to them and continue to stay strong with labor. Comrades, we would want the Hanley family to know that we're sending our condolences to them. As you know, Miss Hanley from Market Street here lost her mom in St. Thomas. The funeral was on the 1st, yesterday. And so we'd want to send our condolences to her and to Bauman and all the rest of them. Jan Jan and Julie and Kenny and all the rest. Also, you know, we had Mr. Percival from Fremont Village, who died very recently. And we would want to extend our condolences to his family, his daughter, Desi Dean, Sonia Alexander, Percival, his ex-wife, his other family members and friends. We want to extend our condolences to them. Also, Mr. Halbert, who was formerly of Navy Street, he used to live there by the girls' school, but now of Taylor's Range, he too passed, and his family is here from abroad. We extend our condolences to them as well. And then we want to say good night to some of our good shut-ins and the people, the elderly people like Miss KB to the alley and Maud Tyrrell. Belated birthday greetings to Maud. We also want to say good night to Viola right here, Viola Harvey, Brenda Manners, and all those people in the area. Nurse Bori, who did so much for health in this country right here in Upper Market Street. We also want to extend birthday greetings to Charles Leibard from College Street, an elderly man through the alley, 99 years old. Put your hands together for Charles Leibard. We also extending birthday greetings to Janet Akers, a lady who made 101. She lives in College Housing, the mother of Nurse Manning, who also did quite a bit for us in the health sector. And we hail up Ingrid Richards, who is sick. We know she's listening to us. Ingrid, we want to wish you all the best. Right? We want to say congratulations to Surrey, Hugh Pemberton from right here. He just opened a radio station over on Victoria Road just on Friday. And he has a radio station in St. Thomas and one in St. Croix. And now he's opening in St. Kitts and Nevis, and we're happy for him. So, sorry, we wish you all the very best in your new venture. But I just want to say that it's important for us to recognize that it is part of our view of what freedom and democracy is all about. Another radio station. So for those who like to go from radio station, like Terry and Sylvie and so on, let them know in case they don't know. We have a new radio station open over in Victoria Road. I had forgotten Mabel Alford, who was buried today. I said condolences already to them, but Charmy, as we know, from Westbourne, got. She was buried today. We extend condolences to her family as well. We also want to say congratulations to our own Ricky Skerritt, Minister Ricky Skerritt, who is now a member, director of the West Indies Cricket Board, and to Jennifer Byron Nero from Shadwell, who is re-elected to the West Indies Cricket Board. And I want to say that we women should feel proud of Jennifer because she's the first woman to be elected to the West Indies Cricket Board, and she's from St. Kitts and Nevis. Actually, she's the first woman to hold a position like that anywhere in the world, any cricket board, even internationally. And so we want to say how very proud we are of her. Full confidence. Here in Central Bastia, First of all, I want to say how very grateful I am to the people of Central Bastia yes. for putting their confidence in me. Yes. I'm here for only 3 years. It come like I'm here for an eternity already. I was elected in 2010. This is 2013. And again, I want to say how very grateful I am, and I want to make the point that come what Herbert was making, and that is, we are elected to be your servants. We are here to serve you. So you don't have to be, you don't have to have any gratitude to me, because we are doing what the Labour Party says. We must do Labour policies. And so what I'm doing is my duty. It is my duty to provide you with opportunities for housing. It is my duty to provide you with opportunities for jobs. It is my duty to provide you with opportunities to get a piece of the land. So it is my duty to do that. So it's not anything about being grateful to anybody, because that is where carrying out Labour's policies. And so it's gratitude to Labour, because there were those who were against the nationalization of the land. And so you have to be grateful for Labour's policies to have nationalized the land so that you can get a piece of the rock. That is Labour's policies. Here in Central Bastia, in the short 3 years, you'd see we have paved quite a bit of the roads up here in Dorset and in Soho and in Shadwell. We did College Street, and College Street got Navy Street and those parts over there, not to mention down in McNair, just up here. And I want to let Alvin know, Alvin, hailing up Alvin and his wife and family, that this part of the road will soon be paved, Alvin. So the young ladies who tell me about wearing the high heel shoes, they can walk more comfortable in the road. So Alvin, this part of the road will be paved. Then right here in Upper Market Street, when we were first elected, we had our big cleanup. You would remember that. First place we had our big cleanup was right up here in Upper Market Street. And you're due on soon again. You'll soon have another cleanup here in Upper Market Street. And since that, we've cleaned up all over. Lower Market Street, Prickly Pear Alley, in McKnight, all over the place. Because that is what we are here for, to keep Central Bastia beautiful. We have also provided jobs for the people of Central Bastia. Young Tristan Johnson from Upper Market Street is a good example. We also did Mui. We were able to give Mui the opportunity to work with Bastia High School, and he's doing an excellent job. And Mui is from Dorset. We had 3 young men from College Street who we just got some employment for. And I want to take this opportunity to thank all of the young people in Central Bastia in the PEP program. When I look at them, I can see that they're very happy to be in the program. And I want to thank those particularly in landscaping who are doing an excellent job over here at the bridge where they are. The young men from Prickly Pear Alley, from up here, from Fines Avenue, those higher up from New Road, and from Shadwell, and I want the New Road set to know that we're working right now administratively on you, and so we're hoping that from Tuesday, you would be able to go. So, Blandina, don't call me no more. Okay. I want to also thank the supervisors like Demi and Sago and all those others who are doing an excellent job in ensuring that these young men are doing their work excellently. And trust me, the same thing is going on in Newtown and all over the country. I met a set of them from Newtown. They come competition now. They say, Ms. Leibold, make it what you say. We up here, we cleaning up the best, come you see. So it's a competition now. But they need to see them in Central first. We know that they're doing the best. Just look and you would see. And we are all very proud of them. And I want you to know something about this PEP thing, because it's bothering the PAM people very bad. And I'm wondering, why doing something for young people hurting them so bad? Is it that they have something against the young people? Sean Richards went on radio and said that all we have for them is to give them an axe and a hoe. We ain't gonna use for them. What is Sean Richards really saying? Everybody got their use. I want to know if the garbage people ain't gonna collect the garbage, what gonna happen? We must respect the garbage men. We must have respect for them. Because everybody got their use. We must respect the drain men. Because they have their purpose and they're doing an excellent job. And we must respect those who are cleaning up in the environment. And we have the greatest respect for them. So I don't know what is his problem. We have respect for everybody and everybody got their role to play. Everybody can be bankers and lawyers. Everybody got a role to play. And sometimes you start one place and you end up somewhere else. You have people like Bernard up here. Landscaping is the livelihood. That's what they do for a living. So a lot of these people who just go out there now can learn the skill and perhaps later on they have their own landscaping business that they go about and do. So they can always learn something from that. So I don't know what is wrong with that. Right now, houses are being built in Central Bastia. And I see some of you right here whose homes are being built at this very moment. And we're going to build more. We have distributed land since I'm there. And I want to tell you that very soon, much more land will be distributed right here in Central Bastia. So you don't have to worry about that. We have supported the preschools in this area. I have supported all of the preschools in this area. And that is why Dorset Park is so important. And as Go spoke about it tonight, I want you to know that some of the funds for it was tied up in the budget. And so we had to wait until the budget is passed. But Dorset Park will be tackled because we intend to turn the upper part, where we used to call the Caesar Park, into a kid zone. Because there's no place for all little people to go out and play. We turn it into a kid zone so that little children could find some place to go and play. And put in a couple of benches so that teachers and parents and whoever is with them can sit while they go out there and enjoy themselves. So we do intend also to change that old stand you see down there and put a brand new stand in Dorset Park. That we're going to do for the people up here. I've also had some scholarships done for Beach Allen. Beach Allen is my alma mater. I went to girls' school. And as you know, Beach Allen is now girls' school and boys' school joined together. And so I offered scholarship to Beach Allen. And the first recipient last year was Alyssa Connor of College Street. Alyssa Connor of College Street. I've also done the same thing for the Irish Tongue Primary School. I've also, for the past 3 years, sponsored a primary school netball tournament for all of the primary schools in Bastia. And you know, netball is my first love. And so I want to see the young girls coming up in netball because I know what netball did for me. It was not just about netball. It teaches you lots of things about life. And so I want the same thing for them. And so I have, for the past 3 years, been sponsoring primary school netball tournament for the schools, the primary schools in the Bastia area. I sponsored King of the Shop Domino competition right up here in Upper Market Street because I know that domino is a big thing up here to the back over there by Ina's shop and even right here by Alvin's shop. And so we're always trying to see how we can assist with the people of this area. Okay. And so these are just some of the things that we have done and are doing in the area, just in this area up here. And we have much more to roll out. But tonight, I want to say to you that everywhere we turn, you hear people on the radio talking about something called unity. But I want to let you know that is just not flying with people. There are more questions than answers.
Yes.
It's like a rudderless boat. And in this world, where there's so much economic and social storms, we can't do with a rudderless boat one in the country. We must have some captain on board to make sure that things are stable. And right now, we are stable here in St. Kitts and Nevis because we have a good captain who is riding the rough seas out there for us. And so we are quite happy with the unity that we have in the Labour Party. Quite happy with that. They say that we shouldn't have any PAM and Labour and CCM and so on. We shouldn't have that. We should just have kitchens and divisions. Well, these two things are not mutually exclusive. When you look at the US, they have Democrats, they have Republicans, but they're still Americans. So why we can't be PAM, Labour, whatever, and still be kitchens and division? Meanwhile, you know, I want you to understand what's happening. While they're telling you, don't be in a Labour, they're still PAM. They're not giving up their own parties, you know. They ain't giving up their own parties. But they're trying to tell you, oh, don't bother with no party. But they ain't giving up their own parties. So don't let them fool you. The only united party you have is the St. Kitts Nevis Labour Party. James Huggins, I want to pick you up, James Huggins. So I can have something. And I want you to see that the leading democracies, the leading democracies all over the world, what you see is that they are political parties who are competing and vying for the leadership of the country. This is normal all over the world. And so we in St. Kitts and Nevis, we deserve to have the same thing. Political parties vying to see who should be the best to run this country. And I know that you have little or no choice, because Labour is the only party with one history, one vision, one symbol, one color. Some of them fighting over color. They don't know if they're blue. They don't know if they're orange. They don't know if they're yellow. They don't know where they be. That is how they're so fragmented. But we have one color. And we have one leader. Straight, one leader. They ain't got one leader. Because they ain't even know who to put as leader. That is how disunited they are. But we have one leader. And we have one mandate. And that mandate is to ensure that the people of St. Kitts and Nevis are given opportunities, regardless of their politics, regardless of their race, regardless of their religion, and regardless of their sexual preference. They must all be given opportunities to further themselves in this country, and that is the promise of the St. Kitts Nevis Labour Party. But comrades, I just want to expose you and show you some of the hypocrisy that's going on in this country. This is the Democrat for August 26th to September 1st, 2006, the Democrat. This was around the time that we were having electoral reform. And this is what it said. Mr. Grant appealed to all stakeholders to allow common sense to prevail and to stand up and be counted. He demanded the resignation of Deputy Prime Minister, Minister Sam Kondo, from the Parliamentary Constitution and Electoral Reform and Boundaries Committee, in light of the very damaging statements made by Minister Kondo about the kind of reform that PAM will get. This is the Democrat in 2006. And then again, the editorial. Of the same date. Furthermore, the Prime Minister has appointed the Deputy Prime Minister to head the Parliamentary Committee, even though he's aware of the very unethical and damaging comments made by his deputy about a kind of electoral reform that PAM would get. Here is the Democrat saying that Sam made unethical statements. They want him to resign immediately. And that is why Sean Richards said they were not taking part in electoral reform until Sam go. They did not take part. They said they're not taking part until Sam go. But what is happening today? What is happening today? Tell me about the unity. Tell me about the unity. Who is fooling who? And then I want to give you another example of the hypocrisy. This is the editorial of the August 26th Democrat headline. St. Kitts Nevis, the homosexual and prostitution capital of the world? With a question mark. That's the headline of the editorial. And this is what they said. The recent suggestion by Prime Minister Denzel Douglas that Caribbean governments should decriminalize homosexuality and prostitution has created an outrage amongst the Christian community and CARICOM neighbors. In fact, the Prime Minister's statements have shaken the moral fabric of our society and forced Kitticians to rethink the issue of political leadership and the requirements of political leaders. The political fallout has resulted in questions about the credibility of the Prime Minister and his ability to lead. So because the Prime Minister said that everybody got the human rights, regardless of your sexual preference, the Democrat took issue with that. Comrades, what are they saying now? Have you heard them recently?
No.
What are they saying now? The hypocrites have now come out.
Yes.
Now that they have said that we should not decriminalize homosexuality because that is wrong. You can't believe it's the same people talking now. Total hypocrites. They stand on no principle. No principle at all. And worse than that, comrades, I want to look at this document, which I want all of you to get a copy of. This is the budget address by the Honorable Timothy Harris. The 2009 budget address. The 2009 budget address. And I want to read part of it to you. And I want you to listen very carefully to it as to what Timothy Harris is saying. Timothy Harris said, "The evidence of our progress as a nation is seen and felt throughout our federation. Between 1995 and the present, the minimum wage enjoyed by low-income groups has increased by over 150%. Some 2,000 low-income families have been afforded the opportunity to occupy their own homes. In addition, we continue to provide free textbooks, free uniforms, free transportation for our students, and examination fees. Additionally, we provide easy access to high-quality primary and secondary healthcare to low-income groups throughout St. Kitts and Nevis." This is not me, this is Timothy Harris. "Hence, our strategy for moving our country forward is not just about presenting fancy economic and financial statistics. It is about touching the lives of ordinary people and ensuring that the lowest income groups among us are protected and that they get their fair share of the income generated for our progressive federation." This is Timothy Harris in 2009. Timothy Harris in 2009. I just want to read one more paragraph for you from the back. Timothy Harris. "You know right now what they're saying is that every single thing over the 17 years was wrong. Very wrong." Timothy said that He supported them because he was young. He didn't know what he was doing. But this is 2009. This is 2009. Then he says, we have traveled a far way forward on the path of progress and development over the last 13 years. We will stay the course of progress and development. We offer our people an enlightened plan to keep the ship of state afloat. We reach out with the steady and caring hand of labor. We envisage an improving and prosperous society with all endeavoring and all achieving in our land of beauty where peace abounds. We are confident, he says, confident that based on our track record of outstanding performance and efficacious delivery, our people can be assured that it is better to repose their confidence in our enlightened leadership, progressive policies, and programs than to gamble with their future and that of our country. Only labor can offer a steady hand, an enlightened plan for a new and prosperous society. Only labor can offer a steady hand, an enlightened plan for a new and prosperous society. And he said a lot of other things, Timothy Harris. And so tonight, I'm asking, will the real Timothy Harris please stand up? I'm asking tonight, will the real Timothy Harris please stand up? Here is he presenting the 2009 budget. Get a copy and read for yourselves. I just read two paragraphs to you. There are many more like that in this document. But today, Timothy Harris is saying for 17 years, nothing happened. Everything went wrong. Nothing happened. But in the budget for 2009, I read just two paragraphs to you. He's saying something different. Comrades, how can you trust them? How can you trust them, comrades? Do you believe that those who they're crying unity with will trust them? No. They got copies of this too. They got copies of this as well. We want the real Timothy Harris to stand up. Let him go on the radio tomorrow and tell us why in 2009 he presented this as the budget to the people of this country. And now he comes to tell us that after 17 years, everything went wrong, nothing right, everything wrong, and all what he agreed to then is because he was young and foolish. This is in 2009. So I want you to judge for yourselves, comrades. Judge for yourselves and see whether or not these are people who you can trust. Judge for yourselves. These are not my words. So I want you, those of you who like to read in particular, get a copy of the 2009 budget. So when they come before you, you can have the hard and the real questions to ask them. Judge for yourself. Come on. And so I want to encourage you tonight to come forward and march with labor on Monday. And I'm asking the young people who are in the PEP and the young people who are not in the PEP to come out on Monday in your full colors and your full numbers and march with labor. Because were it not for labor, you would not have some means of income today. It is labor's foresight and creativity that realizes that you would have also to feed your families. So you have to come out in your numbers and march on Monday. The women have to come out and march on Monday because labor is the best thing for women. It's only today, comrades, only today, I got a draft of some of the benefits that will be derived under the National Health Plan that we're doing for you, the people who have no health insurance. That's what we're doing for you. Because since I'm the minister, I've realized that too many of our people suffer because they don't have the money to pay for the surgeries and so on that they have to take. And so we feel that we need to do something about that. Even those people who have some money, sometimes when they're diagnosed with things like cancer, you want to know where the money gone. Suddenly they become impoverished and their families begin to suffer. And we say we need to do something about that, as a caring government should. And so that is why we are aggressively pursuing that national health scheme to cover those people who are not insured, all of you. Today, I got a draft of some of the benefits. Under that, there will be a funeral grant benefit. Under it, there will be, of course, there will be an ambulance benefit for those persons who have to go abroad. An ambulance benefit. There is something called private duty nursing. That's a benefit that's not even in the public workers plan. Private duty nursing. And that came about because this plan covers many indigent people and it covers a lot of elderly people. And so what the private nursing is all about is for if you had surgery, for example, and then you have to be discharged from the hospital, but you have no one to take care of you at home, or even if you have somebody there, but they perhaps have to go to work, under this plan, they will pay someone to come to your home and take care of you for the period while you are getting better, while you're convalescing. And that is what that private nursing plan is all about. And it includes people who have had deliveries with babies. Once they're not up on their feet one time, they can have access to the private nursing plan. That is part of the benefit to be derived under this plan. And then you have, of course, dental, mental health will be covered. Vision will be covered under this plan. And of course, we would want prevention. And so you must take your annual checkups. Take your annual checkups, because that too will be covered under the plan. So that is why you have to come out to march on Monday. You have to come out and march in full support of the National Health Plan that Labour will soon introduce to cover all of you who have no health insurance coverage. Because we believe that without your health, you have nothing. And the health of the people is still the wealth of the people. So you have to come out and march. The women, as I say, have to come out and march because of the benefits women have derived from labor. Many of the houses that you have, the low-income houses, gone to single women till the men complaining. But they have to understand that very often the children are with the women. The children are with the women, so we're looking after families. And then those of you who have benefited under the WISE program, and some others still to benefit under the WISE program. My friend from the San Domingo, you will get yours soon. Soon to benefit under the WISE program. You have to come out and march on Monday in full support of labor for all you have done to promote women in this country. And then as of next month, look out for the reduction in your electricity bill. Look out for that. And so you have to march on Monday because of the reduction in your electricity bill. Not only that, this government has also been working to ensure that we come off of fossil fuel. And so the alternate energy plan is also on. So we have the short-term plan, which is the reduction in your bill. And we have the longer-term or medium-term plan, that is to put solar systems into your homes, affordable homes with solar systems, to reduce your burden on fossil fuel and reduce your electricity bill. So you have to come out on Monday and march with a progressive government, yes. A government that cares for you and looking after the people of this country. March in solidarity with your leaders. The others, they're leaderless. March in solidarity with your leaders. And we have to encourage those people who are not from here. The Guyanese, the Jamaicans, the Trinidadians from the Windward Islands, the Santo Domingans, all these people, come out and march because your only hope is labor. Look at our history. Our history shows that we were always the only inclusive party in this country. You hear some people talking about Chinese and Nigerians and so on. No, don't bother with them, you know. Don't bother with them. Because Bryant came from Antigua, yes. And they said they sent him back home. Yes. After he lived here for over 50 years, they sent him back home. And he from Antigua. Southwell came from Dominica, and they were sending back Southwell home too. So we are the only inclusive party. And I want to say to you, don't sell your vote out for some beers. Don't sell your vote out for some beers. Because at the end of the day, all you'll be doing is jumping on the scorpion's back. And when you're halfway across the river, you will be bitten. You have to stick with who you know. And stick with those who are upfront with you. Who are honest with you. And I want to assure you that as we speak, we're looking at a new policy for immigration which will regularize a lot of you. A lot of you will soon be regularized. Yes. Your labor government is working in your interests. So come out on Monday and march with labor. The only party that's looking out for you. And you have to march because labor cares about your children. The only party that cares about your children. I remember when we first used to have them pom-pom girls in the march and so on. And they used to be laughing at us and say, what are going with them children? They can't vote. That's how short-sighted they are. So as far as they're concerned, they can't vote. So don't have them in the march. But guess what? Their mothers could vote. Their fathers could vote. Their uncles could vote. Their aunts could vote. Their sisters and brothers could vote. So what is that? And a day will come when they will be able to vote. But so we need to make sure we look after our children. And that is why I, for one, keep my camp every year, 5 years now, for children ages 5 to 12. Because we want to make sure that we mold them and bring them up in the right way. Stronger families, safer communities. And so we have to make sure that we stand up for our children. So I want to tell you what you need to do. Bring your children out on Monday. Yes. We have shorts for all sizes. Yes. Bring out your children and let us have a family affair on Monday. One family affair on Monday where we march through the streets of Bastille in full confidence, yes. And full solidarity with your labor leaders. So bring out the entire family on Monday. And we have to march. We have to march to keep the freedom train going. Because you hear a lot of talk about dictatorship, but again, it's just pure hypocrisy. Yes. I just told you about a new registration that opened. I don't even know how many that makes now, about 12 of them in a small country like St. Kitts. I'm sure per capita, we have more registrations than whole set of places because of labor. Yes. Before Douglas and labor, you'd never had that freedom. When the Prime Minister, Dr. Simon, spoke, every other channel had to shut down. And then they were talking about dictatorship. My mother wrote a board down at Massey's house, and the board is still arrested today. Still arrested. And they're talking about dictatorship. Today, they can go anywhere. Call every radio station. Morning, noon, night and afternoon, till people tired of them now. When people hear them, they're saying, stoops. Tired of them. But that's how it is. Freedom in the country. Don't take that for granted. Don't take it for granted. Because notice what's happening, you know. Pay attention carefully. The minute you don't agree with them, they say, you're chatting rubbish. Total disrespect for you. Or you a $5 prostitute. Are you singing for your supper? Or somebody paying you, but nobody paying them?
That's right,
man. Nobody paying them. Them, they're just talking independently. Nobody paying them. But as soon as you oppose them, it's because somebody paying you. So just as they're saying that, you know, if they were supposed to get in power, you think you'll be able to talk?
No.
Think about it. Don't take your freedom for granted. In order to show that, Monday, you come out and march to keep the airwaves free.
Yes.
March to keep Terry and Sylvie and them talking morning, noon, and night. Because that is where they will stay. Because Labour will be in power and they will stay talking. So that is why you have to come out and march. Because we are happy for them. I tell people all the time, if it makes them happy, I am happy for them. After all, why you want to destroy their happiness? I am glad they are happy. And so keep the freedom train going. So come out on Monday and march with Labour. That is what would keep the freedom train going. And we need to come out and march on Monday because of all the development that's happening in this country. We've been through storms. You hear the song? We've been through storms. But you know what? Only a skillful captain, only an adept captain, only an agile captain, only a creative captain can take you through those storms. Only a captain with those capabilities can take you through those storms. And to all those storms we've been through, look at all that's happening. Groundbreaking ceremony soon for Park Hyatt Hotel, Imperial Bay, Ross University, Christoph Harbour expansion, Scott Cairns development. All of this in a period of storm. In a Kittishan Hill, in a period of storm. What do you call that, comrades? What do you call that? What do you call that? And I said to you, if you have a good leader, you keep him. It's like a love affair. If you have a good lover, you got your good little girlfriend, but somebody soups in a soups. Soups in. But you know that you have your good little thing. You make sure you keep your good man. You make sure you keep your good woman. It's a love affair we have with you. And we in Labour, we love all the people of St. Kitts and Nevis. And I for sure love dearly the people of Central Bastia and the people of Upper Market Street. Because here is where I'm from. And so I have deep roots in this area. And we give all love to you. And that is why we want you to come out on Monday and march in your numbers to ensure that we keep that love affair going. And I'll tell you this, only people who love you can be upfront with you. You don't want them coming to you and saying, that frock you're going to look nice and it ain't true. You don't want that. You want them to tell you the truth. And that is what we're doing. We want to ensure that we're carrying you along the right path. And that is why we said to you that life is up and down. Life is hill and valley. Nothing is smooth. Even the roses have thorns. And so we have to be able to go through the dull times. But you know what? Labour is there for you when you're down. And Labour is there for you when you're up. Through thick and thin, we are there. We are there for you all the time. And that is why we're still here. Tonight, I want to apologize to you for the absence of the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister, who are both in England having meetings with our nationals tonight. But I want you to know, come Sunday, at Pan Pasture, we will have the full slate. And so I'm inviting you and all of you. The mother of all meetings will be Sunday night in East Bastia. And again, come out in your numbers. We have the shirts. And march with us on Monday for all of the things I've said and for all that I've not said, because you know the list is very long. And so, Ronnie, if you could give us back, I'm still here. We're still here. We'll take us home with that. Don't forget, though, tomorrow we have the mini matricade of our contestants. And Saturday night, we have our 8 beautiful girls come to the Queen Show. And our feature artist, RDX, for all the young people, will be at Carnival Village on Saturday. So come out tomorrow to the mini matricade. Saturday to the Queen Show and to RDX. Sunday to a massive meeting. And Monday, we'll see you in the massive match. Full confidence with Labour. Thank you, comrades. Get home safely. Ronnie Lewis here. We're still here.
I've been battered.